Until now, Virtual Desktop has been the de facto standard for wireless PC VR gaming on your Oculus Quest headset. However, Oculus have now released AirLink, their own official way of getting wireless PC VR gaming on your headset. So, which is best, Virtual Desktop, the tried and tested provider, or Oculus themselves, the new kids on the block in this area? Welcome to my tech gear, let's find out. So between Virtual Desktop and AirLink, what are their pros and cons? How do each of them play? Is one of them better than the other, or are they both rubbish? Spoiler alert on that one, I play wireless PC VR gaming and it's not rubbish. And if you think the video isn't rubbish either, then please don't forget to like and share it. And if you're not subscribed yet, consider hitting that button down below and that notification bell so you're notified about new videos as and when I post them. It really helps me grow up this channel so that I can keep making videos like this for you. Thanks. So how easy are each of these to set up? Well, it has to be AirLink that wins in the ease of setup department, which isn't really a surprise as Oculus have baked it into the firmware of the Quest headset itself. You will need version 28 of the firmware or higher in order to get this. You literally only have to turn on a toggle in the beta settings in the Oculus app on your PC and in the experimental features section of the settings options on your Quest headset, and you're pretty much done. For Virtual Desktop, on the other hand, you do have to download an additional app on your headset and also your PC. It doesn't take long, but it is an additional step or two. If you want to know how to get both Virtual Desktop and AirLink set up, then be sure to check out my easy how-to guides for each of them. I'll place links to them in the description down below. In order to get the best experience and performance possible for both AirLink and Virtual Desktop, you will need a good 5GHz Wi-Fi router, preferably an AX or Wi-Fi 6 one, with your PC connected via an Ethernet cable to your router rather than over Wi-Fi, and preferably nothing else operating on your Wi-Fi network either. You should also have a VR capable PC. If you're not sure what spec PC you need, then both my Virtual Desktop setup guide that I mentioned earlier and my Steam VR setup guide as well also go through the PC VR specs. So links to those videos are placed in the description down below. From a configuration perspective, there is some basic configuration available with AirLink, which allows you to change the bitrate of the data stream from the PC to your Quest. When in the Rift home screen on your Quest, you can access AirLink's configuration using the button on the far left of your main menu. You can change the max variable bitrate or change it to a constant bitrate, whichever gives you the most stable connection for your network. Remember that the lower the setting, the less space it will take up on your network, which will make it more accommodating to lower spec networks, but the knock-on effect of that is it will also lower the picture quality. I'd recommend sticking with the default settings and only changing them if you need to. Virtual Desktop, on the other hand, has a multitude of configuration options for you to tweak so that you can get the best compromise of performance versus picture quality for your network. It's not just bitrate settings that you can change here, you can even change the codec that's used to stream the game, amongst a host of other settings. I did a best settings video on this a while ago, if you'd like to go check that out, I'll place the link in the description down below. It's this configuration that really gives Virtual Desktop the edge over AirLink here, as you can change configuration to match a less than ideal network. So it's Virtual Desktop that's going to be more useful to more people here. Both setup and configurability matter for squat though, if they are complete pants to play on. So here I've got some gameplay from Half-Life Alyx, so you can see the comparison between AirLink and Virtual Desktop side by side. Setup wise, I've got both set to a max variable bitrate of 100 megabits per second, so you can see not only their picture quality, but also how each of them handle a variable bitrate. The frame rate is set to 90 frames per second with the default render resolutions. I deliberately didn't set the frame rate to 120 frames per second, which is possible with both Virtual Desktop and AirLink, because in order to get those frame rates, the resolution of the image has to be lowered. 90 frames per second was for me a good compromise between resolution and refresh rate. And for the PC spec, I'm running this on a PC using an MSI 3060 Ti graphics card. Please bear in mind here that what you see on the Quest headset is actually better than what you're seeing on the screen at the moment. This is mainly due to the Quest headset heavily compressing gameplay when it records it, but it is a good indicator of what you'll be presented with on your headset when you're playing. As you can see, both of them did well, and it is actually very hard to tell the difference between the two. For me, I found the picture quality coming from Virtual Desktop to pop slightly better with better colors and contrast, but it's a close call. I had a couple of instances of video stutter on the AirLink too, but it wasn't anything major. Both were also responsive to my actions, and I didn't perceive any delay between pressing the trigger and any events on the screen. However, I wouldn't recommend fast motion games like Beat Saber on Expert Plus mode, as the wireless latency is just going to be too much on either of them. For everything else though, it's more than enough for what you need. AirLink is free as it's baked into the firmware of the Quest headset and the Oculus app on the PC. Whereas for virtual desktop, the Quest app is $20 or about £15. So if cost is your only concern, AirLink wins. So which should you use? Nothing beats free if it's good enough. And here AirLink more than fits the bill. So I'd recommend starting off with that. It is the easiest free option for wireless PC VR gaming. And for a product that Oculus are labeling as an experimental feature, it performs incredibly well. Just bear in mind that you could get issues with it depending on the game and your setup. Here's a couple of issues that I encountered. Don't do anything else on your network when you're playing PC VR games. And this is true for both AppLink and virtual desktop. PC VR takes up a lot of your network bandwidth, so doing anything else on your network, like streaming Netflix at the same time, can have a significant impact on performance. Mesh networks. AirLink has a real problem with this, and I was getting quite a stuttery playback when used, and it's a known issue that Oculus mentioned on their support pages. I fixed that by disabling the mesh roaming feature on my mesh network and locking the Quest to the main mesh node. Once I did that, it was all good. So hopefully that's a helpful tip to people who might be in a similar situation. If after trying various bit rates and frame rate options on AirLink, you are still having issues with performance, then try virtual desktop. It is a more mature product and has more configuration options than AirLink. It therefore allows you to tweak your performance and picture quality to get that perfect balance for you. At only $20, it's not exactly going to break the bank either. It will be really interesting to see how quickly Oculus can mature the AirLink product and offer feature parity with virtual desktop. I can easily see virtual desktop being superseded once AirLink matures, just due to how easy it is to use. Which is a shame, as virtual desktop has been providing a great service to Questers for years, and I really think that Guy Godin, the creator of virtual desktop, really deserves something for his efforts. Simply being overrun by Oculus just seems unfair, especially as Oculus, until recently, spent so long actively blocking the wireless PC VR functionality of virtual desktop, such that you had to sideload a patch from SideQuest in order to get it to work. Thanks for watching. I do hope this has helped you decide whether you want to give virtual desktop or AirLink a go. If you have enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like and share it. Consider subscribing if you're not. And as always, see you in the next one.